Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at the results from my Performance Max campaign. If you subscribe to my channel, then a couple of weeks ago, I released a video covering Performance Max campaigns, and in particular, how to set them up. We walked through the different steps to create and launch a Performance Max campaign, and I thought I'd show you the results from that campaign. First off, if you haven't watched my Performance Max campaign tutorial, then feel free to take a moment to check out that video, as I'm just going to cover the results from that campaign in this video. I've already logged into my demo account, and you can see I have a couple of campaigns running in the account. Since we're just focusing on Performance Max campaigns today, let's select the campaign in the menu on the left. Now, the first thing you'll notice if you're familiar with search campaigns or even display campaigns in Google Ads is that there isn't that much information for a Performance Max campaign compared to those other types of campaigns. For example, if you're looking at, say, a search campaign, you'd see metrics broken down by each of the keywords you're targeting. You can then use those details to optimize the campaign. This is especially the case if you're manually managing a campaign. So if you're looking after things like targeting and bidding, then there's lots of different information available to help you optimize the performance in, say, a standard search campaign. With a Performance Max campaign, it's completely different. They're heavily reliant on Google's machine learning, which means there are a few inputs that we can control in the campaign. So things like our daily budget is important, and the creative for the campaign. This includes, say, the ad copy, as well as images and other assets that I did cover in my tutorial. But when it comes to seeing the results of the campaign, as we can see on the overview page here, we only get very sort of top level performance for the campaign. Overall, they do rely on machine learning along with the objectives that you've chosen. At the top of the overview, we can see the goals that I selected for my Performance Max campaign. We can see purchases and signups. And I already had these configured inside my Google Ads account, and I selected these as my objective when I created the campaign. And we can see that I launched the campaign on the 17th of January. Since then, the campaign has driven over 300 conversions on my website. We can also see the cost of the conversion. My advertising spend for the date range through to the end of January has been just over $500. And then we can see, based on the conversion data, our cost per conversion averaging at less than $2, which is quite good. I'll talk more about this in a moment though. And the conversion rate is just over 3.8%. I want to briefly talk about when I launched the campaign. So if you have watched my Performance Max tutorial, then I actually created the campaign and I began with a $10 a day budget. And because I wanted you to see the results and share them with you, I got a little bit impatient. So I launched on the 17th with a $10 a day budget, but then I decided after watching the campaign on that first day, I only received one click on that day the campaign was launched. And since I didn't want to keep waiting, I decided to bump the budget up. So I actually increased the budget from $10 a day to $40 a day. And that had an almost immediate effect in terms of expanding the eligibility for the campaign. I started to see results very quickly once I increased the budget. A lesson that you might want to take away, or a tip for you, is that you might want to allocate a bit more budget when you're launching a Performance Max campaign. By allocating more budget, you're likely to see greater reach for your ads, which will also help Google's machine learning collect more data to then provide you with quicker results, as we saw in my campaign. So if you've launched a Performance Max campaign and you're not generating any clicks or conversions, you might actually want to allocate additional budget so that you see results more quickly, as I saw with my campaign. After the increase, I kept the daily budget at $40 a day, and it's still at $40 a day at the moment. And we can see on average, it's spending around $40 a day. Sometimes it's a little bit lower, other days it's a bit more, but on average, it's around $40. Also on the overview, you can see other details. I want to highlight a couple of these. On the right, we can see some top bidding signals. This gives you some very top-level insights about what's informing the bids. The bids are automated with our Performance Max campaign, so we can't adjust them manually. We're not doing things like adding bid adjustments or anything like that. It's all happening inside Google Ads for us automatically. But what we can get some insights about Google Ads is actually what's informing that bidding strategy. So I can see here in basically the green is showing us that it's leading signals that are leading to increased bids, and signals that have led to reduced bids are highlighted with a red arrow. This lets us see key things that are impacting the automated bidding strategy for the campaign. So as we can see here, it's providing some insights about keywords. I'll show you another area where you can see some more detail about our keywords in just a moment. Again, the campaign is automated, so you won't be able to control the keywords for the campaign, but you can get some quick insights here on the overview. For example, we can see the query Skillshop, which is actually Google's platform where you can take their certifications and learn more about their platform. So we can see people searching for Skillshop on mobile devices is actually leading to increased bids for the campaign. We can see other signals like time and day. So weekdays after 8 p.m., the campaign is going to reduce the amount that we're bidding. And we can also see signals based on geographic locations and more. Traveling down, there is asset performance. I'll talk more about asset performance in a moment, but overall, Performance Max campaigns have asset groups as opposed to ad groups, which you'd find in a standard search or display campaign. An asset group contains the images, the ad copy, videos, logos, and other elements that we used to actually create the ads people see. So this gives you a top-level overview of the assets in the campaign. You can see we have some headlines here, and it's showing us how the asset is performing. So we can see our top-performing headlines. I'll cover assets again in a moment. Now let's head to recommendations. So far I've found that since Performance Max campaigns are automated, I haven't been given any recommendations. So I haven't seen anything pop up here yet. I wouldn't expect to see too many recommendations compared to say a search or display campaign since the campaign is automated, but I'll check back to see if any recommendations are made. If you're familiar with standard search and display campaigns, Google Ads can automatically highlight recommendations. So this can be recommendations about keywords to target, the bidding strategy, and so on. Now, since the Performance Max campaign is really focused on creative, so images and headlines, I'm guessing I'll see some recommendations to refresh these assets at some point in the future, but I don't have any recommendations yet, so I'll keep looking to see if something pops up. Next up are insights. This actually builds off the cards we were looking at on the overview with the bidding insights, and this could actually be quite useful. To start, we can see details about audience segments. When I created the campaign, we were given the option to choose custom segments, our own data like remarketing audience lists, and other areas to inform the targeting and optimization of the campaign. But here we can see a couple of insights that's picked up automatically. We can see there's audience segments that actually led to a large portion of conversions. These are in-market segments, so people are actively researching or looking to make a purchase. These two segments are interesting since they don't relate at all to my offering. So we have after Christmas sale shopping and Mother's Day dining. This is telling us that people in these segments have a higher likelihood of converting after they've clicked through on my ad. This could actually be particularly interesting if you're running other types of campaigns. For example, you could add these as observation audiences to your search or display campaigns to see if they also lead to higher conversions and conversion rates on those other types of campaigns you're running. You might even use them to inform the targeting or bid adjustments you use with the other campaigns you're managing in Google Ads. Now, traveling down, we can see additional insights. This is one I wanted to talk to you about, which is the top search themes. So this does give you an indication of the keywords people are actually using to find your search ads through your Performance Max campaign. We saw in the card on the overview that the query Skillshop was informing the bidding for the campaign. Now, this is actually quite interesting. We can select the particular keywords, and you do actually get to see the individual keywords people have searched for. This could be a way to actually inform your other search campaigns. For example, if you're running a Performance Max campaign in parallel to a standard search campaign, then you could use this to identify additional keyword opportunities to use with that search campaign. And for my campaign, we can see this is a set of keywords is quite interesting. All of these Skillshop keywords led to a high portion of conversions for my Performance Max campaign. That's something I might want to consider in terms of my strategy when it comes to Google Ads. And you can see traveling down, there are other keyword groups that you could review. Again, these might inform the other campaigns that you're running. I do want to highlight though, if you're just looking to run a Performance Max campaign, then this is really about providing insights. As I've mentioned, it doesn't let us adjust anything. We can't, for example, add negative keywords to our Performance Max campaign. This isn't about targeting or optimization. This is about providing interesting pieces of information about the campaign at this stage. However, that being said, Google has said that account level negative keyword lists are coming and we'll be able to apply them to Performance Max campaigns. I did try and test this out previously. It didn't work, so I'm looking forward to seeing that addition. I think it's going to be a great addition when it becomes available. Next up, we can look at our asset groups. Now, this is going to be important in terms of optimization. I'll talk about this in a moment as we travel through, but basically, these are all the different assets like the different images and ad copy. Let's click to view the details on the right. And this is very streamlined, so we don't get to see things like clicks, impressions, or click-through rate. It's very top level again. We're relying on machine learning. I wasn't sure about this at first, but I quite like that it's really simple to understand what's working and what's not working in the asset group. It tells us the best creative elements in the group. This means we're more focused on really coming up with new assets to try and improve the performance of the campaign. So we can quickly see the best copy, the best images, and so on inside our campaign. And by the way, if you haven't watched my tutorial yet, then this campaign advertises my Google Analytics glossary. So that's what I'm actually promoting with the campaign. And we can see that in this particular headline, Google Analytics Glossary is one of the better performing assets in the group. We can also see the images I've included. And then really interesting, here we can start to travel down. We're going from best through to low performing assets. For my glossary, I included an image of the cover of the glossary as one of the assets, and this didn't actually perform that well at all. So what this means is we can use these insights to decide what we should create next. We might come up with other images or to use in the asset group. Now, for optimization, we can then edit the asset group and replace those low performing assets with new creative. Okay, let's click on the edit icon. And what you want to do is you'll want to remove any of those lower performing assets and then replace them with new assets you've created. You're aiming to improve the overall performance of your asset group and of course the campaign as a whole. We can see all the elements I covered in the tutorial. So we have our images and other assets that are automatically combined by Google Ads to create the ads people see for the campaign. The other thing I need to do for my campaign in terms of optimization is create more videos specifically for the offer. You can add your YouTube videos to use in the asset group. And the other recommendation we can see here at the top is that Google is actually saying you should add some vertical videos to the group. One of the things I found with my Performance Max campaign is that there is a lot of traffic coming from mobile devices. So that's why Google is recommending vertical videos. So that's something in terms of optimization you might want to create if you don't have any vertical video content on YouTube. And apart from adding videos, again, in terms of optimization, we want to replace any underperforming assets with new assets to try and increase the overall performance of the ads that we're running. So that is the asset group. The other thing I just wanted to note in terms of your ads is you can use some ad extensions with your Performance Max campaign. So I'm not quite sure if I covered this in my original tutorial, but what I did do is I made sure to add some appropriate ad extensions to the campaign. So that's another good thing to do in terms of optimizing your campaign. Also in terms of settings, I decided to broaden the location targeting. I actually went with all countries and territories as I was running this as an experiment to show you what sort of results you could achieve. So that's another thing I decided to do with the campaign in terms of targeting. Okay, now let's take a look at locations. Since the campaign is global, we can see there are no particular geographic targets, but I did want to highlight something in terms of optimizing your campaigns and deciding where to target your ads. Now, you may already have a good idea of where to target them, but you can select targeted locations and change this to matched locations, which will show you where your ads have displayed. And this is actually where we get some more granular detail, which we don't get a lot of with our Performance Max campaigns, but we can actually see the different geographic locations. And importantly, we can see things like how much we're spending by location. We can see the number of conversions and the conversion rate. So you can use this to inform the optimization of your campaign. If you find that a Performance Max campaign works well for you and the results look good in terms of conversion and conversion rate, like they do in my campaign, then you might even consider having separate Performance Max campaigns targeting different geographic locations with more targeted offers. That's just one idea to think about. Overall, I'm quite surprised by the results I've achieved from my Performance Max campaign. I'm happy with the number of conversions, the cost per conversion, and conversion rate. So I will be continuing to use Performance Max campaigns in Google Ads, especially to complement other types of campaigns. And as we saw, you may want to use some of those insights, for example, the search queries that we saw, to inform your other search campaigns that you're running in Google Ads. Now, the one thing I did want to highlight here in the graph, and it might be a little bit hard to see because it's only been running for a short amount of time, but currently it's looking like conversions have reduced. So after waiting a bit longer, I would want to check this again to ensure I'm still receiving conversions. If we can continue to see those conversions tapering off, then this might be a result of ad fatigue. So this could be another good reason to switch up the different assets that are included in the asset group. We will want to take the time to create new images, write new ad copy, and continue to maintain the campaign moving forward. The other thing, though, I also wanted to show you is around reporting. As we've seen, it's quite limited, but a couple of tips. First, let's come into all campaigns on the top left corner, and then let's choose campaigns. This is going to show you the information that you can get out of your Performance Max campaign. It's not a lot, but it's worth having a look at. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add a filter. So I'm going to add a filter and I'm going to search for campaign name and I'm going to select this and I'm going with contains and then I'm going to enter Performance Max. And what this will do is it will mean that I'm just focused on the Performance Max campaign inside my account. So I can now see the clicks, the impressions, the click-through rate, and so on. Again, I want to highlight this is all aggregated because everything's automated, of course. Everything is wrapped up together. For example, if we click out of here and choose a segment, we might want to say see how the campaign performed on, say, display versus search. Now, we'd normally use the network segment to actually split the campaign apart, but with our Performance Max campaign, unfortunately, it's all combined together. We just get this cross-network result. It doesn't provide us with any more detail. One thing we can look at, though, and this is a good tip, are the devices people are using. So let's select device. This then gives us a breakdown of how we're spending our budget and the clicks, impressions, click-through rate for the different devices. And I did mention this earlier, mobile was important with my Performance Max campaign, and we can see that here. A huge chunk of the budget is actually spent on mobile devices. And interestingly, what we can also see here is a high click-through rate, a low average CPC, and the majority of conversions are also coming from mobile. So this is something to check and also bear in mind if you're running your own Performance Max campaign in Google Ads. So importantly, you know, where are you sending people to on your website? What's that mobile experience like as people click through to your website, especially if you have a high portion of mobile traffic from your campaign? The other area, though, in terms of reporting that we have available, it is very limited, but if we do choose reports, predefined reports, and then if we travel right down to the bottom under other, we can see there's this Performance Max campaigns placement report. This is the only report we can find inside Google Ads. So let's take a look. This shows us where our ads have shown when ads are shown on the display network. So we get to see the number of impressions and the different display placements for our ads. Again, we can't control these like we would with a standard display campaign. In a standard display campaign, you might choose to target certain placements. You might choose to exclude other placements. It's not possible with our Performance Max campaign. but we can get this detail about where our ads have been shown. I'd love to be able to see conversions by placement as well, but unfortunately it's not available. So again, with Performance Max campaigns, you really are putting your budget in the hands of Google Ads. Yes, it's automated, but I think Performance Max campaigns look really promising. I'm quite happy with the results from my campaign. It's looking pretty good in terms of driving people through to my blog and getting them to download my Google Analytics glossary. So that's my Performance Max campaign. I'd love to know how you went. Did you create a Performance Max campaign? And if you did, what were your results like? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.